Hey, hi guys, this is Sushant, Kochar, and today we are going to talk about a method with which we can get a replacement for, a natural replacement for the protein powder that people usually buy from the market. So usually people buy whey protein powder, casein protein powder, soya protein powders from the market, but we, in this video, we are going to talk about a method with which we can create a trustworthy protein replacement for these protein powders, natural protein replacement. Okay, so generally why would someone buy a protein powder? Someone would buy protein powder because it gives you protein only protein. So it will have calories only from protein, so it will give you protein in less calories. Otherwise, if you eat some other food, it will give you calories from protein, but the calories from carbohydrates and fat in that food will also come with the calories from protein. So you want to isolate the calories from protein. So in general, one scoop of a protein powder would have around 33 grams weight, out of which 25 grams is going to be protein, 1 gram fat and 4 gram carbohydrate. It is just a typical case of a protein powder. So this, in this case, the calories are about 125 calories. If you buy some other high quality protein, then the calories would be even lesser, maybe 110 grams, but it usually ranges from 110 to 125, 130 or something like that. So you want something which gives you around 25 grams of protein in similar range of calories. Okay, so we will derive that thing from cow's milk. So in this case, where you buy a protein powder from the market, you are not sure if the protein powder is actually what it claims to be. It might be cheap steroids or whatever. So it is not trustworthy and it is too expensive. Protein powders are very expensive. So you want a cheaper solution and a safer and trustworthy solution. If your cow's milk, the cow's milk that you buy, is trustworthy, then everything that goes on from now onwards in this video is trustworthy. If your cow's milk is of good quality, then the protein that we derive from this cow's milk is going to be of good quality. So you have to assure that your cow's milk is of good quality, and I'm going to talk about how we can try to assure that the cow's milk is of good quality in my upcoming videos. Okay, so let's say the cow's milk is of high quality. Now 1 liter of cow's milk has around 33 grams of protein, 50 grams of carbohydrates and 35 grams of fat in general. The Indian food composition tables, about which I have talked in my previous video, states that Indian cow's milk has around 44 or 45 grams of fat, but that is usually a case when the cows are fed really good. When they are being fed really green grass and all that, usually cows are not fed that great, so the quality of fat in their milk is not that good. So I would, for this example, I would assume that the milk that we are getting has 35 grams of fat. If you think your cow's milk has more fat than this, then you can test it. We'll come to it. Okay, so the protein in milk has 33 grams of fat, out of which around 8 grams is whey protein and 25 grams is casein protein. This whey protein is the whey protein powder that you buy from the market. This casein protein is the casein protein powder that you buy from the market. Okay. Now, what we want to do is, we want to obtain 25 grams of protein in minimum amount of calories from this milk. Okay. So before this video, in my previous video, I have talked about how you can separate the components of milk, protein, carbohydrates and fat. So in that video, I gave you three methods to separate fat from the milk. One was by getting the fat of the raw milk through the machine, which is in trend nowadays. And then the second method was Bellona, where you would rotate wooden rod in the curd in a utensil, and you will keep rotating it for like half an hour, and the butter will come up, and the buttermilk will stay down, and you'll get the butter out of it, and you'll get the fat out of that butter. You'll make ghee out of that butter. And the third method was you will get cream out of your, the malai from the top of your milk. So when you boil milk and you put it to cool down, there is a layer of fat that comes on top of it. We call it malai, and I will be using malai word for it. So that layer of fat is malai. So the bilona, where you keep rotating that wooden rod, happens on curd, and we want to make sour milk in for what we want to do, and you cannot make sour milk out of curd, so that is not a valid option here. You can, not everyone can buy the machine to get the cream out of milk, so that is also not a feasible option here because it is expensive. The machines are expensive, they even go to 1 lakh plus in cost, so not expensive, and even they need a lot of milk, so is not feasible on a daily purpose in at home. So the only way left is the to get the layer of fat out of milk, the malai way. Okay, so how do we separate all the milk fat by taking its malai out? See, if you boil milk and if you put it to cool down, it will have a layer of fat, malai. If you take that layer of fat, it does not mean that you have taken all the fat out of the milk. There is still significant amount of fat in the milk which has not come to the top. So how do we make sure that we get the maximum fat out of the milk, or all of the fat out of the milk? Okay, so the right way to get more malai out of the milk is to boil it and to put it in a place to cool down where it gets some air on its surface. So maybe near a window where the air passes by, or maybe near under a fan, or maybe near a air cooler where it gets air on its surface. And you want to put the milk in a container which covers more surface area. So I have used this for my example. I have done it with 1 liter milk in this. So I boiled the milk at night and I had put it to cool down in this vessel overnight under a fan, basically in a place where the air of fan comes. So if you try to cool it down in this, this vessel has lesser surface area than this vessel. See, you can see it. So the amount of malai that you would get on this would be lesser than this. So I tried it with 1 liter of milk. With this I got 55 grams of malai, and when I tried with this I got 43 grams of malai. Same 1 liter milk, quantified, different amount of malai, same environment, same fan, almost everything same, but 12 grams of change in the malai that I get. So you try to use a vessel which can covers more surface area. Okay, that does not mean that you pour your milk on the floor thinking that it will cover maximum surface area. You do not want to do such sort of a thing. You do not want to put your milk in a really large vessel, because then the malai that it gets would be really thin, and when you try to pick it up, it would get mixed inside the milk again. It will break. Okay, so what do we do to get all the malai out? What we do is we boil the milk, we put it in this vessel overnight in a place where there is passage of air on the surface of the milk. In the morning, we take all the malai out and we repeat the procedure. We again boil the same milk. We again put it to cool down in a place where some air passes by its surface, air touches its surface, and then we take the malai out again. So in my trial, in the round 1, I got 55 grams of malai. In the round 2, I got 15 grams of malai. In the round 2, I got a bit lazy and I did it. I cooled the milk down in this. So I got around 15 grams of malai. If I had cooled the milk down in this vessel, perhaps I would have got 20 grams of malai. So maybe 3, 4 or 5 grams more malai. Okay. So total I got around 70 grams of malai. If you get cream out of raw milk, around 1 liter milk gives you 60 to 70 grams of cream. So, and this malai experiment gave us around 70 grams of cream, 70 grams of malai. So basically we got the same number. Okay, so we have kind of replaced the machine work. Okay, now around 2 grams of cream or malai would give you 1 gram of fat. So if you try to get ghee out of this cream or malai, 2 grams of cream or malai would give you 1 gram of ghee, and ghee is pure fat. So 1 gram of fat out of 2 grams of malai. So if you got 70 grams of malai, then that means you got 35 grams of fat. Okay, so we have got 35 grams of fat out of the milk, and initially we assume that we had 35 grams of fat in the milk. Now if you think that your cow's milk has more fat in it, you can have around 3 and again heat the milk and take the malai out. You do not have to keep doing it all the time. You can for the first trial or first one or two trials, you can have 3 or 4 rounds and see how much malai you get in the third or fourth round. But according to my expectation, you would get most of your malai in the round 1 and 2. So you would not need round 3 because it takes time. Okay, so basically we got all the malai, most of the malai out of the milk. Now what we want to do is, so this is kind of fat free milk, almost fat free milk. Now what we want to do is get the protein out of this milk. So what we would do is we would pour lemon juice in it, or we would mix curd in it, and we would stir it, and the milk should be hot, and then we would again boil it, and the water separates from the solid part of the milk, the solid white part, which we call chhena or paneer, and the water separates. So I have talked about this separation in my previous video in detail. You can go and check that video out. Okay, so the water part is the contains the whey protein and the lactose, and the solid part is the casein protein. So you got your 1 scoop protein replacement as the solid part, which contains about 25 grams of protein, almost zero fat, and almost zero carbohydrates, because all of the carbohydrates, all of the lactose went into the liquid part along with the whey protein. Okay, so what do we do with this whey protein, the liquid? Well, you can ask someone else to drink it because you are trying to save on calories. That is why you did all of this. Otherwise you could have just drank the fat-free milk, or you could have just made curd or yogurt out of it, and you could have just drank it. Okay, so you can ask someone else to drink this milk, to drink this liquid, or you can use it to make dough. But remember, if you eat the chapatis or roti or falka made out of that dough, that means you're getting the calories from this whey protein as well as the lactose, the carbohydrates. So keep that in mind. So basically you got your 25 grams of casein protein as the solid part, solid white part of the milk that we call chhena or paneer. Okay, we got it. Now we'll do some calorie calculations. So if we took 1 gram, 1 liter of milk, it had 33 grams of protein, 50 grams of carbohydrate, and 35 grams of fat as per our estimation. 1 gram protein and carbohydrate has 4 calories each, and fat has 9 calories. I've talked about this in my previous videos, you can go check them out. So 33 grams of protein has 132 calories, 50 grams carbohydrates has 200 calories, and 35 grams of fat has 315 calories. Total comes out to be 647 calories in 1 liter milk. When you get when you got all the fat out of that milk, you got 315 calories out of that milk. Let us assume that we did not get all the fat, 1 or 2 or maybe 3 grams of fat was still in there after our 2 rounds of malai separation. So let's say there is still 3 grams of fat in that milk. The carbohydrates, almost all of the carbohydrates goes into the liquid part when you make sour milk, when you separate the solid and liquid part. So, but let's say that there is still 1 gram of carbohydrate and we got the 25 grams of casein protein. So the total comes out to be 131 calories. So this fat, so the fat that you took out as malai, if you didn't take that fat out as malai, and if you had created, if you had tried to make sour milk by pouring lemon juice in it, then the fat would come with the solid part of the milk along with that casein protein in that white part. That is why if you leave 1 or 2 or 3 grams of fat in the milk after taking malai, it would come in with your protein. That is why we have considered that there is still the 3 grams of protein, 3 grams of fat with your protein, and merely 1 gram of carbohydrate. So basically you got your protein in 131 calories, and what you buy from the market is around 125, 120, 130 calories. So basically you have the replacement of 25 grams of protein, which is expensive and it might not be safe and trustworthy. Now you have a replacement for it as a trustworthy source which you can make at home in front of your eyes. You know what is present in it, what is present in it, and it is much cheaper. So if your milk costs 40 rupees per day for 30 days, 25 grams of protein would cost 1200 rupees. If you buy 1 kilogram of whey protein powder, it would cost you around 2000, 3000, 3500 rupees. So it is quite cheaper and safer. If your cow's milk is of good quality, if you have assured it, then everything happening here is of good quality. Okay, now if you can get 25 grams, so basically the conclusion is, get the malai out of your milk using this process twice and pour lemon juice or curd in your milk and get the water out and solid part out, and the solid part is your protein powder replacement of 1 scoop. Okay, got it. Now that does not mean that you take 4 liters of milk or 5 liters of milk and you make 100 or 125 grams of protein out of it and you keep eating it, because that can be that excess of everything is bad in general. So you might not want to do it because so there will be calcium in that chhena or paneer, the solid part, there will be calcium in it, and if you eat like 4 liters of milk chhena, then that would be a lot of calcium. And if you drink milk, if you eat curd, and if you drink buttermilk along with this, then there will be a lot of calcium for going in your body for that day. You might not want to do it. So doing this for 1 or 1.5 liters of milk should be fine, I guess. If you do it for 1.5 liters of milk, you get around 38 grams of protein. I think that is fine. That is around 1.5 scoops of whey protein powder or casein protein powder. Whey protein digests quickly, but you do not want a really high spike of protein in your blood. So meeting your protein requirements from the casein protein is not a problem. It is not a bad choice. Okay, so, and yeah, one more thing. If you think that if by having this protein from chhena or paneer gives you all the nutrients of milk, then you do not need to drink milk, that is not correct. Because the liquid part of milk that you separated took away the vitamins or minerals that were soluble in liquid. So the liquid part took away a lot of nutrition. So if you want the nutrition that is present in the liquid part of the milk, you would want to drink milk, or you would want to have curd, or you would want to have buttermilk. All of these contain the liquid part of the milk. So having this protein as a replacement does not mean that it is a replacement for milk. So this information would be quite unique for the internet, I would say. So if you really like this and you would want people to see it, please share it with your friends, those vegetarians who are worried about getting natural protein in their diet. or affordable protein in their diet. And those non-vegetarians killing chicken and eggs, you can share with them too, so that they can have their non-veg getting replaced with this vegetarian option. So you can share this video with your friends and family and help them, and you can be uplifting lives and saving lives. If you like this video, like, comment and share. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.